it's Talia here. Welcome back to another video on my channel. Today's video is something that I'm super excited to share with you guys. So if you keep up with my social media, I posted about my Raskog cart, oh gosh, a few months ago now. And I have been meaning to make a video sharing with you guys how I'm using it for my filming desk, which is right behind me here. So I typically sit this cart right beside me when I'm gonna film, and I have everything that I need for filming ready to go. Essentially, it's technically like a second nail desk because I have like a light, I have my brushes, I have my isopropanol alcohol, I have my nail stampers, I have anything that I need to do any sort of nail product review videos sitting right beside me. So I wanted to set up like a whole essential different nail desk, but at the same time, I don't need it for clients. So I don't need like an armrest, I don't need anything like that. So this Raskog cart works perfect for it. I'm so excited to share it with you guys. So why don't we jump in and I will give you a tour of my cart for filming. Okay, so this is my Raskog cart. It is a three-tiered cart, again from Ikea. It does not come hot pink. I spray painted it hot pink. So before I assembled it together, I spray painted it all and then I assembled it. It looks pretty good from a far distance, but if you look up close, there are some like imperfections, I guess you could say. And also it's kind of like, if you scratch anything on it, the paint kind of wears off. So it doesn't hold super well being spray painted, but I love this cart. So on the top, you guys can see that I have some plastic inserts. That's what I'm gonna share with you right now. Is I got my IKEA order in. I'm gonna actually be setting up a second one of these carts to sit at my nail desk. I'm gonna clear everything off of my nail desk and put a lot of stuff in this cart. It's a different cart though. That's actually not an IKEA cart. It's one that I got from Costco, but I will be sharing that all in a separate video, and it'll be like a desk organization video. And in that video, I'm gonna share with you how I'm gonna be setting up that cart to work right beside me when I'm working on clients. So I had to order some more of these inserts, which again, I got from IKEA. So I'm gonna show you those quick, then we'll jump back to the cart. Okay, so the inserts that I got are from the Godmorgan series from IKEA. So they have two separate series that you can get, and these are made to go in the Raskog carts. So this is the first series that you can get, and it comes with three little bins, and then it comes with kind of like a longer rectangle bin, and then it comes with a giant bin here. And you guys will see those more in depth when I do the actual tour of the cart. Okay, those are the names of them. So if you guys are wanting to look them up or anything, you'll get a better idea of what they look like. So this is the second one. So in this one, you get this giant organizer, and then you get this kind of separate one, which you can either put in the giant organizer, or you'll see soon that I keep it separate. And then it also comes with this little divider, which would be great for certain sizes of nail polish. I don't actually use that divider. I just found with everything that I needed in my cart, I didn't actually end up using this, but I ordered two separate sets of those because I wasn't sure if I needed one more for my filming cart or if I needed four for my other cart. But again, when I set up that other video, you guys will get a better look at these. I just wanted to show you what these are because we're gonna show you them on the cart here. Okay, so on top of my filming cart, I have the large Godmorgan organizer. Godmorgan, I'm not sure how you say it. And in there, it comes with this, like, this is stuck in here, this divider, same with this divider here. This is one of those brush holders that I got from Canada Nail Supplies, and I just keep it tucked away in that one. This side here, I keep for any sort of filming equipment that I need. This is an attachment that goes on top of my iPhone, which I can attach to my tripod if I want to film like live videos. This, I'm not even sure what that one's for. This, again, I can hook up my iPhone and put it on a tripod. I don't use this one very much, but I do keep those attachments there in case I need it. So this is that separate insert that I was telling you guys about. You can easily put it inside this organizer on this side if you want it, but it actually tucks away really nicely in here. And so in this organizer, I keep a pair of scissors just in case, usually for cutting like names when I do name tags. I keep a clear jelly stamp or scraper. I keep a brush for any sort of dust. And I keep one of my Light Elegance 180 files, as well as one of the buffers. I sometimes need these if I'm doing nail art. I keep a lint roller for stamping, and I also keep like a box opener just because sometimes I have boxes that I need to open at my filming desk. So like I said, I do have a brush holder that I keep right here. In the brush holder, I have two of my Light Elegance Oval number 4 brushes. I have one, I need to actually cover these because they are kind of close to a window. I keep one of my LCN Pro NA Protect one, I can't remember what it's called. I use this for glitter. And then I have a Wildflowers one stroke brush, which I was playing with. I have a silicone tool, and I also have some tweezers here. So there's definitely room to grow if I'm finding that I need to be reaching for more brushes in this organizer. This side here, this is again one of those Godmorgan holders. I keep empty swatch sticks as well as black and white swatch sticks in case I need to do any stamping or anything. And it just tucks really nicely in here. And you'll see that that whole organizer fits like perfectly in my Raskog cart. I also keep one of these pearl brush holders, and this is from Impact Salon Sales. I was actually using, you'll see on the side over here, I was using these brush holders at my filming desk, and I just don't like them as much as I like this one. I like that this one keeps like my brushes really, really off the desk. I really, really like this. So I wanted that for my filming desk, but I don't like to keep that stuff on my filming desk because my filming desk has multiple purposes. I use it for filming, I use it for editing, I use it for planning, I use it for a whole bunch of different things. So I like to keep a lot of stuff off of my desk, and that's why this cart comes in handy. I also have one of like those tip holders if I'm gonna do any tip designs with that. And then I have a wipe holder. This is from Walmart actually, and in it I keep my Ducal wipes, which I use for nail stamping. I keep my Light Elegance wipes, which I use for like everything else. And then there's this perfect compartment here for Q-tips as well. And again, that just fits like perfectly here. I keep some nail polish remover in one of these pink pump bottles. Both of these pink pump bottles are from Canada Nail Supplies. And in this one, I keep 99% isopropanol alcohol. It's nice because these different sizes fit perfectly here. This one is actually way more compact. So I would maybe look at getting some of these if you wanted to take up less room in your cart. Okay, this is a little bit more tricky to film here, but I do have the giant storage unit right here, and you'll see that it comes with lids. The lids aren't overly necessary, but I do really like having them. They kind of just keep everything clean and organized. This I use for any of the gels that I need. So what I can do is if I'm finding that I need color comparisons or anything, products that I think need to be compared to different ones, or if I need to run and grab more products from my actual nail studio, I just take this bin over, fill it all up with whatever I need, bring it back over, and then when I'm done filming, same thing, I can bring it all back over to my nail studio. So it's just an easy cleanup. This is actually one of my favorite things to use for my filming station. And then I have one of the longer rectangle containers right here. This I keep full of swatches after I have swatched them. So from here they either move into a ring that I keep at my nail desk for new products, or else they get filed and put onto like the different colored rings that I have. And I have two more of those little containers right here. And in these containers I keep the little tips that go on top of these type of organizers. So I have the square ones in this little compartment. And right next to it, I have the like almond shaped ones. I just like to keep those separate. Right beside it, I have one of my grip and tips from Danny Co. I use this a lot for like top glosses or primers or anything like that. These I believe are discontinued, but you can find similar looking ones, just not the Danny Co brand, on like eBay, or I think I've heard that you can get them on Wish or AliExpress. So I'm not sure what you would search to look for that though. In the back, actually I'm going to turn my cart around so you guys can see what the back looks like. I keep my Soft Landings towels in this one. These I use a lot for stamping, or if I'm going to do any sort of like 3D acrylic or anything, I just like to use my Soft Landings towels. And this is a perfect little organizer to kind of tuck away in here. And then I also have some tape. I can't really pull this out, but it is like shaped like a pink high heel. I use tape for different nail designs. Typically that's all I really use tape for. Right beside it, I have a pack of my Young Nails Nail Trainer One Size Refill Pack. And I use these for my training hand. Okay, this is gonna be the hard drawer to kind of show you guys because it's really low here. But on the bottom, I just keep some of my other filming stuff. So this, I actually haven't tried. I've been meaning to, but it goes on your phone. Okay, so I actually haven't tried this, but it is a ring light for your phone for taking pictures or videos or anything. I just need to put a battery or get a battery for this, and then I'll try it. But I've had that for months and I still haven't tried it. I also keep a cloth here because whenever I work or do swatch videos or anything, I like to have a towel on my lap to wipe like gel or alcohol or anything off on. I keep my label maker down here, which I use to label all of my swatches. This is an old Light Elegance nail lamp that I use at my desk, but I just like to keep it tucked away for when I'm not using it. And then this is a makeshift tripod. When I actually film, I will film like a tour of my filming setup eventually, I will give you guys more details on what I use for like my camera, my lighting and stuff like that. But this is a makeshift tripod. So what it is a lamp stand and then it just has a camera attachment put onto it. So I didn't make that though. Actually, Rob from Can West made that for me and it actually works really, really well. And then I just have some backgrounds at the bottom here. So I have a marble background. This is actually a cutting board from Walmart. I have a fusion background, which I haven't used that in quite a while. And then I also have just a plain white background. And then I have these ones with my old logo on. I'm getting a new logo made. And these mats are actually from a lady who I guess no longer makes them because a lot of people are having problems getting a hold of her. So if you guys are interested in having mats made, the Cheryl from Fusion, her son Daniel actually is making mats. And when I get that video, when I get my new mat in, I will share it with you guys. So you guys can have like his contact information. I'll leave that in the description box below too, if you're interested in that as well. But that is my filming cart setup. I absolutely love it. I use it every single time that I film videos for you guys. It's functioning really, really well for me. Like I said, I love it so much that I am getting one for, or gonna set one up for like right beside my nail desk as well. I'm just finding on top of my nail desk is driving me bonkers with how full it gets of products and everything that I'm using during my appointments. So I want a cart like this so that I can clear some of that mess off. So I will 100% film setting up that. I'm hoping to get it done this weekend or the next weekend because my desk is again driving me nuts. So, but yeah, like I said, I will film a video for you guys sharing my whole filming setup, talk about the camera I use, the lighting that I use. That's not high on my priority of filming lists though, but it is on there. I know that a lot of people are curious as to like how to film YouTube videos and hopefully I can make a video helping you guys out. But I wanted to give you a full video of that cart because I know a lot of people are curious on how you can use one. I freaking love that cart. Like, I want one of those in every single room in my house. I think, this is like completely unrelated to nails, but I think that like with next baby, if I had one of those in a nursery, in baby's nursery right beside my nursing chair, I would fill it with like all my nursing essentials. Like, I have so many ideas for those carts that like, I swear Steve is gonna be so annoyed with how many carts we're gonna have eventually. I think a planning cart like that would be great for like an office. Again, I'm gonna have one at my nail desk. Like, I seriously want one of those carts everywhere. I think it functions so nice. And if you take the time to organize it really well, I feel like it doesn't look like cluttered or anything either. So anyway, I wanted to share this video with you guys. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you guys use one of these carts for like your nail desk, or what do you guys use these carts for if you have one? I'm super curious. Make sure you follow me on all my social media and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.